Game Show Network. All play, all day.
Let's all play What's My Line? And now let's meet this week's What's My Line panel. First, the religiously funny Soupy Sales.
Thank you. Thank you, and thank you, Chet Gould. It's a pleasure to welcome back to our panelists the lovely, beautiful actress who you've seen so many times in the movies and on television. Would you please welcome Joanna Barnes?
And on my left, an absolutely splendid plaid jacket wearing Leonard Harris.
Joanna Barnes is from Boston, and so is the lady on my left. And when we are finished here, are we going to have a tea party? Arlene Francis.
Tea party, huh?
Well, now, I want you to meet the Spanky of our gang, Larry Blyden.
Hello, all bodies. Soupy, listen, I heard that you were a big, huge, fantastic smash at the Pfister Hotel in Milwaukee with your nightclub act.
Thank you.
That's what I heard.
That was, they had me, that's on the Pfister roof. Nobody took a chance to book me in a closed room. it's the people in Milwaukee said to say hello to everybody because What's My Line is very big there.
Hello,
okay.
Milwaukee.
Isn't that lovely? Hello, Joanna.
Hi, Larry.
Listen, I have something here you're not going to believe.
Oh, please.
It's a book called Who is Carla Hart? And it was written by Joanna Barnes.
Who's that?
Joanna Barnes?
Carla
Hart? That's the second from the left over there. The only thing that's really wrong is that it doesn't have any pictures. But then it would probably, you could only get it in very special bookstores if it did. Who is Carla Hart that Joanna Barnes wrote? It's had marvelous reviews and it's a marvelous book. You'll like it.
I'll tell you how great it is. I'm $480 overdue at the library.
I love you.
And it's not that long. You can read it in one sitting, really, and have a marvelous
sitting. That's what you're
going
to do instead of the show, right?
Yeah. Right. Well, listen, speaking of the show, we have a marvelous one, and would our first guest to prove it enter and sign in, please? Lily. Lily Pulitzer. Now, if you ask, what is a lily? Most people will answer that it is a flower. But fashion-conscious women will quickly add that a lily is also a very popular and colorful type of dress created by fashion designer Lily Pulitzer.
Yes, indeed.
Lily is with us because she has designed a new line of clothes. And we will show our audience what the new line is.
Glad you came to play with us today.
Thank you. This is fun.
Okay, now let's start the questioning with Leonard Harris, who is quite a lily himself.
With me and the new and a new line of clothing.
Right.
I don't even know what we're supposed to know about this new line of clothing.
Right.
And you're not going to tell me.
Right.
Well, then I'm going to ask a very simple question first. I assume it is women's clothing rather than men's.
Yes.
Wow.
All right.
Wow.
Well, it's men and women's, but in this case, we're dealing specifically with women's clothing.
This new line, which we're supposed to identify, is it an unusual material? The materials, are they unusual?
No, they're not.
One down and nine to go, Arlene. Only in the sense that they're customary, the look of them may be unusual because of what she does to them, but they're not. Arlene?
Well, I admire all the things I've ever seen of yours, but if this is new, I haven't seen it yet. Could it be something in a lingerie line that you've designed?
No, it's not.
Two down and eight to go, Soupy.
Is it anything that is used in a sport of some kind?
Yes, it is.
And is this an outdoor sport mainly, generally?
Yes.
Is it a sport that's played with a ball?
Yes, you might say so.
Would you have a new line on tennis outfits?
No.
Three down and seven to go, Joanna.
Oh, the football up.
Oh, it's very close. Now, wait just a second. I was sure it was tennis, and it's played with a ball. Mm-hmm. Gracious sakes alive.
I'll give you one hint. It is not jeweled face masks for professional football players.
Thanks, Larry. You're a big help, as always. Oh, I love the lilies that I've seen, but we have a game that's played... Well, it can't be baseball. Is it a game played predominantly by... It's played by both men and women.
Yes.
I can't think... Is it a team sport?
Not necessarily. Four down and six to go, Leonard.
May I assume it's a game in which you don't perspire?
I don't think that we can.
That's hard
that
to say, Leonard. I'm not sure you can assume that. I'm really not. Five down and five to go, Arlene.
Well, it's either swimming or golf, isn't it? It's one of those.
Is that your assumption?
Okay. I mean, you could play ball in the water, I guess, but I'm assuming that it is one or the other. Is it by any chance golf?
It is golf. Golf fashions for men and women. But before we get into the golf fashions, how did the original lily come about?
The original lily I started because I really have, without question of a doubt, I think the squarest figure in the world. I mean, there's no waist, there's nothing. And I had them made, and I live in Florida, and they were the most comfortable and the easiest things. I wore them long and short. And then I started selling them along with my ex-husband's fruit. And they took off like mad, and that's where we are today.
The fruit.
Yeah.
Now, that fascinates me. Was there some kind of connection?
Not really, other than my ex-husband had oranges and grapefruit.
And you had
dresses. And I had a couple of dresses that people seemed to like, so I threw the whole thing together.
That's good. $1 a dozen. Okay, those days are gone, folks.
Right.
Just so everybody knows what we're talking about, here's Jennifer in the original lily, which has remained basically unchanged for the last 10 years. Right. Now, Lily, what are the basic features of that?
I think basically we're known for our color and our very clear prints. And the majority of our dresses have lace on them and pockets. And actually, nearly any age can wear them. You know, they're not just for 30s or 20-year-old people. They're ageless.
That's really marvelous. Thank you, Jennifer. Thank you very much. Now, how did you get into the golf scene?
The golf started about 3 years ago with our men's stuff. And we have a line of very bright, colorful men's pants and what have you. And that was so successful in the golf that we found that a lot of ladies were wearing our just regular skirts on the golf course. So last year we decided to go into golf in a big way.
Do you choose those colors for emotional reasons, or do you think it has anything to do with being in the South and the colors? And
we're basically a resort. You know, I think resort. I live under a palm tree, and I can't think kind of city life very well.
Okay. In honor of Women's Golfers Week, Lily has arranged a small showing of her ladies' golf fashions. So, Lloyd, if you could... open the curtains, we'll take a look at the 18th tee. Zappo.
Here's Nancy Grigor looking cool, crisp, and colorful in her golf outfit. She has a sun-protecting yellow scarf and a most comfortable orange cotton long-sleeve shirt coupled with her wrap-around skirt and shocking beet print trimmed with waffle pique and orange rickrack braids.
Good looking.
Hey, thank you, Nancy.
Thank you.
I love you. Thank you. A little golf cart work there.
Here's Anne Hadorn wearing for her golf match this practical floppy-brimmed yellow hat that matches her sunshine yellow short-sleeve shirt, blended with my golden apron front lace-trimmed skirt that features a most useful back pocket.
Okay, thank you, Ann.
Done.
Here's Elaine Fulkinson. She's wearing a very easy-moving apple green sleeveless blouse, complemented by my squash print polyester trim skirt. As you can see, I've designed a front pocket, which most golfers find quite essential on the golf course.
Thank you, Elaine.
And here's Jen
Jennifer again. This time she has slipped into my after the match golf fashion. A simple but cool scoop neck blouse, accented with Shifley embroidery. Her long skirt features bold floral colors, accented with white lace trim.
And that's for after the match, I guess.
That's for after.
That's lovely. Thank you, Jennifer. We'd like to thank you, Lily, for Golf Digest magazine, originators of Women Golfers Week, and Abercrombie & Fitch for the golfing accessories. They're really marvelous.
Aren't they fun?
Yes, they are. And thank you for bringing them to What's My Line. Good luck. Thank you.
We'll be back with more of What's My Line right after this message.
Tonight, you have two chances to play Inquisition from home, if you dare. First at 7 Eastern, 4 Pacific, then a new game at 9:30 Eastern, 6:30 Pacific. Live, interactive, all you need is a touch-tone phone and nerves of steel. Inquisition only on Game Show Network.
Izzy, this cold, I'm so stuffed up. Feels like I'm underwater too. The sneezing and coughing can last all night. My eyes won't shut either. I need NyQuil for relief so I can rest.
Because I have plans in the morning.
What? I can't say.
With NyQuil, he gets relief, so he'll sleep and wake up to a good morning.
Don't look.
NyQuil, the nighttime sniffling, sneezing, coughing, aching, stuffy head fever, so you can rest and have a good morning medicine.
Hi!
Where have you been, Doris?
Oh, I'm sorry I'm late, girls. I had to get a new gift for Charlie.
Oh, what did you get him?
Best thing I ever bought him. It's something that'll remind him of me every day of the week.
In parked cars?
You know how we're always bumping into things, pulling our cars into the garage? Well, this will stop us.
Let me see that. It costs $7.50 to fix my bumper.
$12.60 for the minivan.
And what did it cost to fix the wall?
No more bumper bashing for me, girls.
I thought you said you bought it for Charlie.
Yeah, isn't life sweet?
In independent studies, cars were tested hitting walls at 5 miles per hour. No car went undamaged. Repair costs ran from about $400 to $2,500, depending on the make of the car. So if you've ever had to shell out numbers like these for bashing a bumper or whacking a wall, you need ParkZone. Right out of the box, ParkZone sets up in two easy steps. Simply hang it on the garage wall using the screws supplied. ParkZone is loaded with sophisticated circuitry. Then, with your car in position, depress the activation button. This sets the precise distance between the ultrasonic sensing device and the bumper and locks it into memory. It couldn't be simpler. As you enter your garage, the green light illuminates. Midway, the amber warning light comes on. Then, when the light turns to red, you stop. You're in the park zone. No ifs, ands, or bumps.
Depth perception is a common problem. The last time I hit the wall, it cost me a bundle. ParkZone's my solution.
Everyone in my family benefits. We're in and out all day. Parking is one less thing to think about.
Look, all you need is one good whack a year, and you'll wish you had one. And it'll cost a lot less than your deductible.
ParkZone. It simply helps you park your car safely.
Isn't life sweet?
To order ParkZone, have your credit card ready and call the toll-free number on your screen. Or send check or money order to ParkZone, 1 Penn Plaza, New York, New York, 10119. Call now for holiday delivery. Park Zone. No ifs, ands, or bumps.
Since I started using Vanish Hangins with bleach, I have the cleanest smelling toilet in the neighborhood. The Vanish dispenser delivers more bleach where it makes a difference, in the bowl. More bleach to the bowl means a clean toilet. Vanish Hangins, with the dispenser that delivers more bleach.
This is my grandpa Giovanni. Nobody tells stories like he does. Give him good food and good people, he'll charm you all night. That's how it was last night at the Olive Garden. Where everything feels more like family, more Italian. Then, out came the chicken scampi. It was perfect. Pasta and sautéed chicken covered with this rich garlicky sauce, plus all the salad and breadsticks you want for $8.95. What a feast it was for all of us. Our ears, too.
You're beautiful.
The Olive Garden. When you're here, you're family.
Thank you, Chet. You were brilliant that time, panel. Simply brilliant. Let's see how you are this time. Would our next challenger enter and sign in, please? Gail Buchanan.
Where are you from?
Auburn, Alabama.
Okay. Panel, Gail Buchanan is associate professor of crops at Auburn University. He is a specialist, and we will now show the audience in what he specializes. And we'll begin the questioning with Arlene Francis.
Well, I presume it isn't the boll weevil. Do you specialize in something that grows?
Yes, I do.
And would it be part of the grain or vegetable family?
It could be.
Now, I tell you what I'm going to do, Arlene, because I'm such a warm...
I'll tell you what I'm going to do.
Tell you what we're going to do.
You're going to give me a no.
Yeah, I tell you, the only reason I'm going to is that it is a puzzling thing, and ordinarily most of us who don't know much about his field of expertise would be puzzled by that answer. So in order not to lead you...
But not I.
Nevertheless. In order not to lead you into grain and wheat, we'll have one down and
grain
nine...
Grain and vegetables.
Grain and vegetables. We'll go over one down and nine to go soupy.
Look at the intro I got. Mr. Buchanan, does this, what you are expert in, does it grow above the ground?
Usually, yes. All right.
When it is eaten by person, is it usually at a dinner time or, you know?
I don't know that we've established that it is eaten.
Is it ever eaten?
Occasionally it could be, but not usually.
Two down and eight to go, Joanna.
But it does grow above the ground, no. And it is not a grain or a vegetable. Might it be something that was either a tree or a fruit?
Three down and seven to go, Leonard.
No.
It's not a tree or a fruit. No. I gathered from the nature of this questioning, all of which was be no better or worse than mine, that it's not one particular thing, but rather a kind of thing. Is that right?
That is correct.
That was the only good question I had.
Super. Quit while you're ahead.
All right. It is not cotton.
That is correct.
That is correct.
That is correct.
It's not cotton. That is correct. Right. I just saw a number move, and I
push it right
I'm
back.
I'm nervous enough as it is, but is it something? It is something that's not normally eaten. Is it something that's normally used by the human in a way other than being eaten?
No, it's not usually used by the humans.
Four down, six to go, Arlene.
Is it something that drives me crazy in the garden? Is it weeds?
Yes.
It is weeds.
Yes.
Panelists, two for two. Arlene came through twice in a row. In addition to being the associate professor of crops at Auburn University, Gail Buchanan is also the editor of the publication Weeds Today.
Oh,
see, dear. Weeds have their own magazine, I suppose. I didn't know that. What kind of weed research are you doing?
Well, my major area of research is weed biology and weed ecology. I also do a considerable amount of research on evaluation of new herbicides and new techniques of using herbicides to better and more effectively control weeds.
Tell me, are weeds necessary ecologically?
No, they're not necessary. I know we've been seeing a good bit of information in the press regarding the good side of weeds, and certainly we can utilize weeds to some extent. We can make dandelion wine. We can have dandelion greens. But when I look at all of the cost and loss of food that's produced in the world, and I look at all of the misery that weeds cost people in time, they aren't necessary.
Go get them, Mr. Buchanan. Thank you for being with us always. We'll be back with the appearance of our mystery guest right after this message.
No one knows more about the safety of pain relievers than doctors and hospitals. And the pain reliever they choose most? Tylenol. Why? Because doctors know Tylenol is least likely to have drug interactions, and it won't cause stomach irritation the way aspirin and even ibuprofen sometimes can. For over 20 years, Tylenol has been the first choice of doctors and hospitals. When safety matters, Tylenol, the pain reliever hospitals use most.
New Quaker Rice Cakes. 60 calories, never tasted better.
Yeah, sure. Remote time.
Oh, no, wait, look. New caramel apple with creamy caramel chips.
Ooh, I haven't had that since I was a kid.
Mm, and new cinnamon streusel topped with rich cinnamon chips.
This I've got to taste.
Well, then, take a bite.
Mmm. And they said interactive TV would never catch on.
New Quaker Rice Cakes. Taste is the reason you'll be surprised.
Can I try the caramel apple?
From Game Show Network Studios and the acclaimed director of We Got Game comes the exciting prize-winning thriller of the season, The Critics Are Raving. Now you can get into the game. All you have to do is watch a clip, answer a question correctly, and you're the star. Silver Screen Flashback, featuring Steve Saunders, is playing on a television screen near you. Weeknights right between the classic and new newlywed game around 8 p.m. Eastern, 5 p.m. Pacific. This game has been rated G.
Hey, lady, isn't it about time to change that Glade plug-ins refill?
Refill your Glade plug-ins every 45 days to keep your home Glade fresh.
Plug it in, plug it in.
This is my grandpa Giovanni. Nobody tells stories like he does. Give him good food and good people, he'll charm you all night. That's how it was last night at the Olive Garden, where everything feels more like family, more Italian. Then, out came the chicken scampi. It was perfect. Pasta and sautéed chicken covered with this rich garlicky sauce, plus all the salad and breadsticks you want for $8.95. What a feast it was for all of us. And our ears, too.
You're beautiful.
The Olive Garden. When you're here, you're family.
All right, let's get a little wood on that thing.
I'm a scout. I better know a good thing when I see it. The first USA Platinum Visa card, it's a good thing.
I find bestsellers for a living, and I'm sold on First USA Platinum Visa.
I can tell a winner. Here's a tip. Invest in platinum. Switch to First USA Platinum Visa.
You know a real winner when you see it. So switch to First USA Platinum Visa card and get a low introductory rate of 3.9% for 6 months.
I transferred the balances from my other cards onto this. Then I paid a low rate and saved a bundle. Stats don't lie. This card's a winner.
After 6 months, enjoy a low 12.99 fixed annual percentage rate. First USA Platinum Visa means low rates, high benefits, like emergency airline ticket replacement, $3,000 lost luggage protection, and auto rental collision coverage.
Seattle on Wednesday, New York on Thursday, and on Friday, my husband and I leave on a vacation cruise. This goes where I go.
Plus, you get a complete year-end summary of charges, 24-hour priority service, and platinum prestige.
Switch to platinum, and people will notice.
You'll have a credit limit of up to $100,000. And what do you pay for this privilege? Nothing. You've earned it. You're responsible. You know how to manage your finances. Call now and we'll make a sweet deal even sweeter with this garment bag and amenity kit, free with first purchase or balance transfer. Platinum Prestige, Platinum Benefits, with a low 3.9% introductory APR and no annual fee. Call now and switch to a winner. First USA Platinum Visa.
Call now to apply for your First USA Platinum Visa card. Get a 3.9% introductory APR. Credit limit to $100,000. No annual fee and with first purchase or balance transfer this free garment bag and amenity kit. Call 1-800-869-7151.
Next up, you can fill in the blank with Match Game, followed by celebrities airing their secrets on Tattletales and Extreme Entertainment on Extreme Gong.
Okay, we're back, and we have an extra minute or two, so why don't we just, for giggles, play a little round of Who's Who? Lloyd, could we have the curtain open, please? Here are four folks who have graciously consented to play Who's Who with us from the audience. One is an administrative assistant, one a beautician, one a typist, and one a psychologist. All you have to do is hand out the card so that each person holds the card which states his or her occupation. We'll start with Leonard. You have 20 seconds on your mark. Get set. Go.
See,
This particular part of the game is probably the greatest test of intelligence on this entire broadcast.
This part of the game here.
I think so.
Leonard has gotten it twice this week is the reason he says that. Would you tell us who you are, please?
I'm Carol Tubman from Fort Worth, Texas, and I'm administrative assistant.
Cecilia Junkowski, typist, Brooklyn, New York.
Lloyd Naramore, Shaker Heights, Ohio, psychologist.
Mabel Roberts, Macon, Georgia, beautician.
Okay, thank you very much. Well, because Leonard Harris is such a wise guy, you didn't fool the panel, so you haven't won any money, but we do have a gift for each of you, and thank you for playing Who's Who on What's My Line.
Each member of the Who's Who team will receive a Samsonite Silhouette beauty case, a new wild strawberry color featuring magic action pop-up mirror. Samsonite, we make travel a little easier. Larry.
Okay, we're back. We're back, and now it's time for the special feature of What's My Line, the appearance of our mystery guest. Are your blindfolds all in place, panel?
Yeah. Yes.
Then would our mystery guest enter and sign in, please? Okay, panel, we'll go one question at a time. If you come up with the wrong answer, you're out. And let's start with Soupy Sales.
Don't start with me, man.
Oh.
Thank you, Larry. Mystery guest, that was a marvelous ovation. Is that because we'd find your name in the entertainment sections of the paper?
Mr. Soupy, your assumption is correct.
Joanna?
That's a funny accent. Have you ever had a television series on a regular basis?
Oh, yes, half television series.
Leonard?
You didn't meet Larry Blyden in the flower drum song, did you? Do you have a television series now?
Oh, yes, half series now.
Eileen?
Cat, maybe it's Charlie Chan revisited. Are you, do you play a character older than a young leading man in this series?
Oh, Miss Frances, your assumption is rousy.
That's an old soup. Soupy?
Well, did we run into each other at this afternoon?
Oh, no. No chance.
Oh, Joanna?
Then who I thought it was.
You have a television series. Are you also doing a play?
Also doing play? No, the play.
Yeah. Leonard?
Well, let me try a network. Are you on, and out of loyalty, I first say CBS?
I have no loyalty to anybody.
I was talking about mine, not yours, fellas.
CBS? Oh, yes, sometimes CBS.
Eileen?
Oh, it's obviously a syndicated show. It's not a syndicated show.
Is
it a comedy show as opposed to a Western or a doctor show?
Oh, sure. Sometimes funny, not so funny.
The biggest laugh of the day, because we're out of time, is going to be when you take your masks off and see Mark Goodson.
Oh, my God, no!
You want to know something?
What?
After all these years, that's the funniest I've ever seen.
Really funny. Yeah. Funniest ever been, right?
Really? Great. Just great.
That is absolutely
I think it's the... Did we miss you ever before? Ever? I don't think we've ever missed you before.
No, but the Japanese got to you.
The Japanese got to
you. That's great. That's great.
Nice to see you, Leonard.
Funny.
Boys, come in. Click everybody.
Your hairdo is adorable, Joanna. Nice.
Thank you. Right. It's shorter than yours.
Yes. I saw Joanna just about 2 or 3 days ago in Los Angeles.
Yes. You were all decked out in your beautiful black tie, looking extremely handsome.
No clothes, just a black tie.
they're wild out there in California. You know, most people, Mark, don't really know what shows Goodson Todman has done in the course of its existence. What shows have you done?
He doesn't know either.
Oh, well, what we have on the air right now, we have Out of California, we have Password, and we have Price is Right, daytime with Bob Barker, and then the evening with Dennis James. And then we have Beat the Clock Out of, which is done in Canada, which is broadcast throughout the country, What's My Line, and To Tell the Truth.
We'd all like a raise.
Yeah.
That's a mess of shows.
And, of course, my favorite is this one.
Isn't that
nobody here let's hold him for ransom until we get a raise.
Okay, what's happened here is that we're out of time. Goodbye, everybody. We'll see you tomorrow.
Game Show Network. All play, all day.